Hey y'all, welcome back to Doug's Cars. It's Lincoln Day here. I'm getting to review two Lincolns today, two videos on Lincolns. But this one is one you may not have heard of, and it is called the Mark LT. Lincoln Mark range was usually a series of large, very luxurious personal coupes, starting in the 60s. Actually, I believe in the 50s. But this is very, very much of its era. This is the Mark LT for luxury truck. This is a four-wheel drive, very highly optioned, one generation only, although more about that in a second, pickup with a bed on it that's actually usable. You can, you know, real tailgate, real scratches. This has been used as a pickup truck, as it should be. Now, Lincoln had a previous pickup truck called the Briarwood, which is a two-wheel drive one with like a power bed top lined with carpeting. Those sold terribly. So instead, Lincoln decided to go with another F-150 based vehicle, because again, this is based on a Ford F-150 and is the precursor to some of the really nice F-150s we have now, the Platinum, King Ranch, and all that. However, this, despite also being available with four-wheel drive unlike the Blackwood, also didn't sell very well for whatever reason. The Cadillac Escalade EXT sold better. It did have the midgate, which I always thought was a good feature on the Cadillac, and of course this doesn't have that. This is just a regular four-door cab, but it really ushered in all of the really fancy high-end trucks we have now with the air-conditioned seats and everything you'd find in a luxury vehicle. Why did these fail? I don't know. They just didn't sell that well. They sold around about 10,000-12,000 a year for three model years, 06, 07, and 08. We only got that one generation of these in the US. Now in Mexico, they did have a second generation. They sold better there for that marketplace. I was unable to find numbers as to how many sold in Mexico, but they liked this one there so much that they got a second generation. I've not driven this generation of F-150 or Mark LT, so this is new to me. I've driven the more recent generation, the first generation of aluminum-bodied F-150s, but this will be new to me. But look at it. I mean, it is unmistakably a Lincoln. You've got a Lincoln grill in front with a giant, look how big the logo is. That's my hand. It's huge. You've got, you know, you've got chrome everywhere. You've got Lincoln down there on the steps on the side. You've got Lincoln there on the giant wheels. I mean, those are 18s. Those are pretty big for, you know, 2006. And then you, of course, got this beautifully luxurious interior. It's just, you know, way above what you would expect in an F-150, but it is still F-150. I mean, it's got the same, you know, plastics as an F-150, but it's got this lovely embossed leather armrest. You've got embossed seats front and rear. All of the controls you could possibly imagine. All power on the driver's side, of course. You've got wood trim, although I don't believe it's real. Doesn't look like it's real wood trim, but still very classy. And you know, this one was available as a four-wheel drive. It's got pretty good back seat room. We even got climate vents back here. Again, more embossed leather fold-down center armrest, and you have the contrasting piping stitching. All these things will show up on F-150s that replace this. I mean, you know, they're 75, 80 grand now. And this was a pretty expensive truck for its day. So I've never driven one of these. Let's take it out on the road, see how it drives, and see what it's like driving a 15-year-old F-150 with some really nice interior appointments. All right, hopping in the cab, you can see there's your switches here that are, again, very F-150, but you've got the Lincoln gauges here, and this one has just over 80,000 miles on it. You got a lot of silver trim. You've got silver trim buttons here on the leather-wrapped steering wheel, which looks like it's two-tone leather. It's been used, obviously, but you can see the color variation, I believe. And your four-wheel drive switch, you've got this leather and chrome shifter. And then, of course, you have Lincoln written here. All right, let me get the camera set up, and we'll go for a drive. Safety first, of course. There we go. I just realized this has a 6-CD changer. Man, that exhaust sounds good. That is not factory. Lincolns don't sound like that. So we've got single zone climate control, heated front seats, rear parking sensors. Now, this vehicle didn't sell so well, considering it was based on probably the best-selling vehicle of its time and still to this day, the Ford F-150. The F-Series pickup is probably the best-selling vehicle every year for decades. And with good reason. I can bring the whole family along. I can tow a boat. I can tow a trailer. And, you know, This is just a more luxurious version of it. I just don't know why they didn't sell that well, because obviously when you get into more modern F-Series pickups, they have all of these fancy features and they sell very well. Now, the one Achilles heel of these, and the reason you probably don't see too many of them, is the 3-valve 5.4 liter V8 under the hood. Those are notorious for timing, chain, guide issues, and you know, that's just not a Ford issue. BMW's had that with all of their modern V8s, and they're just very expensive to replace. And you know, this pickup's worth enough money that you could do that. So yeah, so wow, the brake travel is, I mean, I'm driving a big truck, but the brake travel is really, you really put your foot down. Yes, love that, that sounds so good. Yeah, it drives really well, actually. The brakes, I don't think there's a problem with the brakes on this vehicle as it stops, but the brake pedal travel is really far. It's just further than what I'm used to in any of my vehicles, but I'm not gonna say it scoots, but you know, it's a big, heavy pickup truck, but it gets out of its own way for sure. I think these had right around 300 horsepower. And you know, if you maintain these, you're not going to have those issues. I get a little bit of the bouncy back end because it is a pickup, and Fords especially do that when you go over bumps, you know, with an unladen payload area, you're going to have that issue. Yeah, this drives really well. I get it. I get why these F-Series sold so well. What I don't get is why these Lincolns didn't. Is it because it's a Lincoln? Because they were selling every Navigator they could build, and Cadillac certainly sold plenty of Escalades, and the Escalade EXT, their pickup truck version with that midgate I mentioned earlier. Maybe it wasn't as luxurious as it could have been. I mean, there are still a bunch of plastics in here that were held over from the F-Series, and I can't say that they're cheap plastics, because I think they're meant to be durable. And again, this is a working pickup truck. You can put anything you want in there and haul it, but I don't know. I don't think that the Escalade interior was any better, though, than this, especially back then. The Escalades now have nice interiors, but the Lincolns have totally blown them out of the water. The new Navigator, I mean, is gorgeous inside. I mean, even like people like DeMuro say that, and you know, he drives everything. That sounds good. This aftermarket exhaust, you've got to love a V8 with an aftermarket exhaust. I'm really digging this thing. You're up high, you've got great mirrors. So there's a bit of wind noise now that I'm going about 40 here on this two-lane country road that's kind of curvy. But I mean, you know, you've got the sunroof shades open, so that's going to contribute a bit. This is a quiet, I could see driving cross country in one of these, absolutely. The rumble is no longer existent from, you know, driving out. I'm cruising right about 50 miles an hour here. And it is definitely not difficult to drive at all. This is quite a pleasant experience. I imagine that the, you know, the Platinum or King Ranch version of the new F-150 is even more enjoyable of an experience, just because things have progressed so far in these 15 years, and of course the engines are much more powerful as well. This 5.4 3-valve, if you watch any of the Car Wizards videos, he's always upset with this engine. So when I was out in Wichita to pick up that vehicle that I purchased from Tyler Hoover, there's a guy that they all know who rents out a bunch of vehicles on Turo, and he had as one of his vehicles a Lincoln Mark LT. And one of the Car Wizards early videos, he's actually rebuilding that engine, or actually installing a rebuild engine, I should say, because there's been so many failures of these. And when I went out there, I rented a Range Rover Sport from Bob, and he met me at the airport in his Mark LT pickup. And I've liked them when they were new, and I still do. And it's nice to know that meeting my hero, so to speak, although this is not my hero, but I've always liked these, is not a bad thing. I really like how this drives. It makes great noises. It's very comfortable inside. It is not a sports car, but it's not designed to be. And I get why people like these. And I get why these are sought after now, because these are way more sought after now than they were when they were new for some reason. I just, the brakes are not up to my, I mean, you know, I drive a lot of BMWs and things like that, so the brakes are going to fall short in that area, but it's just a lot of pedal travel. Once you actually engage the brakes, they work. It obviously has, you know, four-wheel disc brakes. This is a big, heavy, modern vehicle, but wow. A Jetta driver was not happy with me, and this sounds so much better than that Jetta with the fart can exhaust it. So yeah, that's That's the Lincoln Mark LT. These are like 15 years old now. This is pretty well screwed together. It doesn't really rattle. There's one little noise I hear. Granted, this one only has 80,000 miles on it and it's been very well maintained. But if there's something that you're interested in and you know that the engine has been either replaced with a better remanufactured one or it's been taken care of like this one has, this might be a wise option. This might be something worth checking out. So Lincoln Week's gonna continue here because very shortly there'll be another video. The same family has graciously allowed me to test both of their Lincolns. So stay tuned for that. And please hit subscribe so you can see that other video too coming up soon. Thanks y'all so much for watching Doug's Cars.